Hey everyone, it's Lindsay and David from Everyday Ohana Magic, and today we are going to show you all the seashells we've collected at the Jersey Shore.
Yeah, all these shells obviously were found in New Jersey, pretty much throughout all the state.
Yep, and I found one of them.
Big help.
And Isabella found a few too.
She did.
But she found one really, really nice one. So we'll show you guys that one too.
And these are all the shells we found. And that little shell there with the circle around it, that's the one Isabella found. And here's another look at Isabella's little shell. And that first shell with the circle around it, David actually dug that up. And we had to include this shell that Isabella painted. And the last shell is the shell that I found.
Those were all of our big seashells and a couple of smaller ones too, including the cute one that Isabella found. And we also have some more that we want to show you.
These are one type of shell. Mm-hmm. Same type of shell in the canister.
Yeah, I think it looks really pretty in the canister.
Now this canister is from Bed Bath & Beyond. It's acrylic, in case, you know, Isabella gets to it or something.
Yeah.
Safe. I also found these shells. They remind me of the Shell gas station logo, except they're black and there's some white ones. I believe the Shell one is yellow. But eventually these will go in some type of canister as well.
Yeah, and it will look pretty cool because they're all the same. So, neat design.
Now we'll give you some hints of how to find the big shells that we found. Number one's kind of important. You have to be lucky.
Yeah. That's for sure.
Yeah, so the best time to go is for low tide, and sometimes they're sticking up maybe a half inch out of the sand, so sometimes you actually have to dig for them.
And you have to be lucky enough to also find an unoccupied shell.
Yes.
So we only take, obviously, unoccupied shells.
If it is occupied, which we have seen, just put them back in the water. Let them be.
Yep. I think another useful tip is to actually search close to the water. Like, bring your rain boots and just search close to the water. It worked for me.
Or sandals if it's the summertime.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But in the winter, rain boots so you don't get cold.
Yeah, definitely the water line is a good place to look. Also, you'll see if it's low tide, there's like usually a line of other shells or seaweed. Check that too, because sometimes there are some bigger shells up there as well. And I'd say the best time to look is the off season. So up north, it would be from November to maybe April, May.
Yeah, April probably.
Yeah.
Because the more people there are, the more difficult it gets, because people find them and then they take them.
Yeah, so it's the opposite, I guess, in Florida. That would be from May to probably September.
Yeah.
A useful tool to bring is something just like a shovel that you could kind of sift the sand out. It's also it's a very useful tool that I've used.
Yeah, and also like if you have to dig the shell out a little bit. Like one time you actually like were digging, like you just found a shell.
The problem with digging is you don't know if the shell is occupied until you lift it up, but luckily it's unoccupied, so
it
worked out. It was just very heavy from all the sand.
And also another thing that we do when we get home, well, I do it, is I clean all the shells and then I put them in bleach just to get like the sea smell off of it, like that. Sometimes it has just like an odor to it. And also it cleans the shell too. Like if it has any like barnacles on it or anything like that, you could actually scrape them off by using the bleach.
If you have any other tips for us or any useful tips for other people, please let us know. And also, if you have a favorite type of shell, we'd definitely be interested in hearing that.
Yeah, let us know in the comments below. But if you like this video, please be sure to subscribe, give us a thumbs up, and like we said, comment below. Thanks so much for watching and stay safe, everyone. Bye-bye.